Hello and welcome, my dear students of class 7. Earlier we have learned about different kinds of nouns. Today we learn about nouns number. Now what is number? Number means count. So in English language there are only two numbers. So let us see, what do you mean by number? A word which explains whether the given thing is one or more than one is called number. So if the thing is one or more than one, so the word which explains this, it is called as number. For example, my son is very intelligent. Now here you can see the word son. Another example, my sons are very intelligent. Now in the first example, son, it denotes only one number. It talks about one son, hence this noun is said to be in singular. In the second example, my sons, your sons is more than one, hence this noun is said to be in plural number. So in English language we have only two numbers, that is singular number and plural number. So let us see the definition of singular number and plural number with examples. Now singular number, a noun which denotes only one person or thing. So noun which tells us about only one person or one thing, it is said to be in singular number. For example, chair, ball, boy, book, class, etc. So all these words denote only one thing. Hence, these nouns are said to be in singular number. Now, what is plural number? A noun which denotes more than one person or thing. So if the noun is more than one, so it may be 2, 3, 5, any number. So more than one, so the word which denotes the name of more than one person or thing, then it is called as plural number. So same examples, we can make it plural. For example, if it is one, then it is chair. More than one is chairs. One ball, many balls. One boy, many boys. One book, many books. One class, many classes. So have you understood what is a noun number? Noun number means singular or plural. Now singular, which denotes only one person or thing, and plural means which denotes more than one person or thing. Now let us learn the rules for changing a singular noun to plural noun. There are certain rules to change a singular noun into plural. So let us see all these rules one by one. So the rule number one is by adding s to the singular noun at the end. Now for example, bag. So after adding s to the bag, it becomes bags, which is a plural noun. Coat, coats. Orange, oranges. Window, windows. Book, books. So by adding s, we can change a singular noun into a plural noun. Second rule is by adding es at the end of a singular noun which ends in s, double s, ch, sh, x and o. So the noun which ends in s, ch, sh, X and O. So these nouns take ES at the end to make it plural. For example, glass. Now it ends in S. So we have added here ES to make it plural. Now bunch, CH. So the noun bunch ends in CH. So after adding ES to bunch, it becomes plural, bunches. Box, it ends in X. So it takes ES, boxes. Brush ends in SH, it takes brushes, ES. Bus, buses. So the nouns which ends in S, double S, CH, SH, X, O, for example, tomato, tomatoes, potato, potatoes. So these nouns take ES to make it into plural. But there are some exceptions. Here, for example, now see the word stomach. It ends in CH, but it does not take ES. It takes only S. So the words which ends in CH but makes K sound. See the word bench or bunch. It has ch sound. So the word which ends in ch sound, it takes ES to make plural. But here, even though the words ends in CH, stomach, it ends in CH, but the pronunciation is stomach, k sound. So it takes S and not ES in its plural. There are certain words which ends in O, but they take only S in plural form and not ES. For example, photo, photos, video, videos, radio, radios, piano, pianos. So these are certain exceptions to the rule. Even though these words ends in O, it doesn't take ES in its plural form. Okay, so these words you have to keep in mind. Now let us move to the third rule. If a singular noun contains Y in the end and a consonant is placed before Y, then it is changed into IES. Now already you know what is a vowel and what is a consonant. A, E, I, O, U. These are vowels and the rest of the letters are consonants. So if a word ends in Y and before Y if there is a consonant, then Y will change into IES. Okay, for example, baby. Now B A B Y. Y, the word ends in Y, before Y there is B which is a consonant, and so we have to drop this Y and add IES. So baby, babies. Similarly, family. Now it ends in Y, before Y there is L which is a consonant, and so we have to drop Y and add IES. Body, bodies. Story, stories. Country, countries. So now here you have to keep in mind that if the word ends in Y but before Y if there is a vowel, if there is a vowel before Y, then it will not take IES. For example, if I say toy. Now this word also ends in Y, but before Y there is O which is a vowel. So if there is a vowel before Y, then we have to just add S. Toy, toys, boy, boys, and not IES. This thing you have to keep in mind, that only when there is a consonant before Y, then Y will change into IES. But if there is a vowel before Y, then only you have to add S. Okay? Let us move towards the next rule. Rule number 4. Some singular nouns can be changed into plural by changing the F or FE into VES. Now the words or the nouns which ends in F or FE. So that F or FE will be changed into VES. Let us see the examples. Thief. Now it ends in F, thief. Thieves. So we have to drop F and add VES. Half. It ends in F. So drop F and add VES. Halves. Life. Ends in FE. So drop FE and add VES. Life. Lives. Knife. Knives. So the words which end in F or FE, it takes VES in the plural form. But here also, my dear children, we have some exceptions to the rule. So these are some exceptions: chief, chiefs; gulf, gulfs; safe, safes; roof, roofs; cliff, cliffs; proof, proofs. So these words are exception to the rule. They don't fit in the rule, in this rule. So these words you have to keep in mind. Let us move ahead. Some singular nouns can be changed into plural by changing internal vowels. Internal vowels means the vowels which are used in the word, in the middle of the word. So by changing those vowels, we can turn a singular noun into a plural noun. For example, man. Now M-A-N, A is a vowel, man, which is in between. So by changing A into E, we can change a singular into plural. Man is a singular noun and men is a plural noun. Next, tooth. O will change into teeth, E. So the vowel O is changed into E. Foot, feet. Axis, access. So by changing the internal vowels, mouse, mice; goose, geese. So by changing the internal vowels, we can change a singular noun to a plural noun. Now rule number 6. Some nouns have the same form in both the number, whether it is singular or plural, they remain the same, they do not change. So the examples are ship. So either it is one ship or many ship, it remains ship, it will not change. Hair, in its singular form, in its plural form, hair will remain same, it will not change. Fish, deer, news, furniture. So these are some nouns which do not change in singular and plural. In both the cases, they remain the same. Okay? I hope you have understood all these 6 rules. Thank you.